and much more social. But then also when looking back at the first speaker, he was saying that we need to create a dance floor. Well, maybe the opposite of Aline, I always like to think really big. So I would like to challenge you, Sander, to say not only a dance floor, but let's make it a whole festival. Because I'm Linda and I'm the director of InnoFest, helping innovations to test at festivals. The world around us is constantly changing. An enormous cliché. I know. But nevertheless, I start my speech with it, and I started fully embodying to this, because I think it's super important. Because the way that we deal with a change, most of the time, that's not actually really given. And the choices that lie behind it touch the core of what Islands of Innovation, but also what InnoFest does. Whether it comes to climate change, diversity, or tackling the corona pandemic, if we change at all, it usually is really, really, really slow. At InnoFest, we want to be open to change, also to the changes that are somehow less convenient, that mess up our plans, and also make us insecure. To embrace these kind of changes is not always easy, as we have seen since the outbreak of COVID-19. As a result of the following pandemic, a lot of our plans ended up in the trash. For example, Welcome to the Village was supposed to open its door this summer to, for us, 8 innovations who wanted to test their prototypes there. However, very shortly, before it was going to end up its doors, before the opening, it turned out that the festival was cancelled. The festival sector has had, and still has, a lot of uncertainties. However, the protests throughout the Netherlands show that the festival sector is not giving up. A group of smart, passionate, and creative people with vision from the north of the Netherlands, including Simon Thijsma, came up with an idea that festivals are not only a place to relax, to drink a beer, to listen to music. No, it could also be a place where sustainable startups could test their prototypes. By testing in a realistic setting, entrepreneurs obtain crucial feedback in a short time to further develop their products. They collect evidence on their path towards a successful market launch. A brilliant move, I think. Because while large companies may have the resources and the networks to roughly test their innovations, for many starting entrepreneurs, this is yet not possible. So we test the prototypes, and we help these starting entrepreneurs to do that. Because assumption is the mother of all, and we learned that making mistakes is so important, but you can only do that if you dare to be vulnerable and dare to see what kind of failures you can make. And how does this look like, testing startups at a festival? I would love to show you this clip.
En het is de hele wereld op een hele kleine schaal, waardoor het perfect testen is.
The Great Wide Open is a fantastic place for us to test because it's our target demographic and there's no better place to test this than in a forward-thinking festival.
We willen graag kijken of het echt werkt ook. Groeit er daadwerkelijk een plantje als je het in de grond stopt?
Ons is heel mooi dat we hier hebben kunnen testen, omdat dit ook heel erg dichtbij komt bij wat wij in de openbare ruimte tegen.
We moeten zorgen dat de gebruiksgemak, de ervaring super blijft en we blijven dit voortdurend innoveren.
En we willen kijken of festivals hiermee ook leren hoe mensen tegen dat geven aankijken, zodat je misschien daar nog meer mee kan.
The current plan is to adapt and make all the changes that we've learned from the festival. And then we also want to pilot a test with a new prototype somewhere in Africa.
Op dit festival hebben we nu in een paar dagen tijd vele honderden mensen in deze douche gehad. Daarvoor is zo'n festival fantastisch.
Ja, op Oerol willen we graag testen, omdat we dan veel meer locaties hebben op Oerol. Daarmee krijg je veel meer input om te kijken wat er wel goed gaat en wat er niet goed gaat.
Dus op een festival in een tijdelijke situatie kunnen wij eigenlijk exact nabootsen wat wij straks in de werkelijkheid op een vluchtelingenkamp ook tegenkomen. En dat dankzij InnoFest.
Het belangrijkste wat ik wel heb geleerd vandaag is dat mensen het gelukkig heel lekker vinden.
En de snacks lopen echt als een trein. Als de zon schijnt en hier tegenover staat best wel mooie witbiertjes, dus het vliegt eruit.
Forced by the pandemic, of course, we need to do things differently. We need to reinvest and reinvent InnoFest. So how did we do it? We came up with an online version of testing, which was called InnoFest Test TV. But we also spread our wings and went to different living labs, other sites. For example, Stortemelk, which is a campsite on Vlieland, one of the small little islands up in the north of the Netherlands. So this is actually what's going to be the link of today with the symposium. I'm going to shortly take you to three innovations that we've tested on a few of the islands. So let me start with this one. It's a sustainable hot shower. At Into the Great Wide Open in 2019, Hemmos ran a test to see whether its heat recovery module returns the same saving in the real life as it does in the lab. At the Into the Great Wide Open festival, Hemmos tested its system at the festival campsite. With so many people using the shower, Hemmos was able to verify whether the 60% of energy saving achieved in the lab also held up in real life. They did. So that's actually a good thing. And the added benefits of testing the shower system at a festival campsite was also that it allowed Hemmos to study whether the system would work and would continue to work even if there were enormous amount of dirt. Coming through this part of the test with flying colors as well, the shower system is now ready for its market launch. A second one is Kumasi, an additional source of income for cacao farmers. At the Oerol Festival, Kumasi tested this cacao juice drink. It is made of residual products from the cacao industry, and it gives farmers an opportunity to boost their income. At 2019, at the Oerol Festival, the developers of the drink handed out taster sample to the audience to see whether they liked it or not. Luckily, the people were really enthusiastic, and it's now seen in a lot of stores. But you can also buy it online, and you also see it a lot in cafes, because they really want to be a substitute for example, cola or Fanta. This year, they started with us testing again, and this was actually a project that we also did together with InnoQuarter. It was called InnoFest Test TV, and it was again with Oerol, but now online. So 100 people got the drinks of Kumasi at home, and they gave online feedback. And the special thing that we actually found out is when you are online, and probably you all know this, people are much more honest. So the feedback was also much more harsh. And this actually would really, of course, helps the entrepreneurs because they want to have, of course, the best product so that you want to buy it again and again and again so that they can really, really make an impact. And the third example I'm now going to show is the super fast composting of green waste. The EcoCreation tested whether festival waste could be processed into usable compost within 24 hours using this composting machine. This test was done together with Lab Vlieland. EcoCreation developed this technology to turn green waste into compost and to convert all the food waste and compostable disposable at this festival. Although this provided many learning points in terms of logistics, the systems helped up well technically. Not only could this be a great innovation for a festival, but I would say also for islands more in general, as transport to an island is quite costly and also has, of course, a negative effect on the footprint. EcoCreation is currently being developed at festival as well as in bigger organizations, for example, as Laplace, which aim is to further scaling up. So we started in 2016, and we now tested 200 cases, and more than 11 festivals already opened our door, and currently and luckily also other living labs have opened the door for us. To further professionalize our support for the startups, we wrote a white paper in which we share our methods with anyone who wants to know more about experimenting or wants to know more about setting up a successful innovation test. The white paper can be downloaded and it is for free, so if you want to know more, please go to our website to check it out. And this is Friso, and maybe some of you know him. He's also one of the people in my team. He's head of the methodology, and he's a Leeuwarden innovator, so I'm really proud to have him in our team. We, as InnoFest, are determined to make a positive impact, even greater within these coming years. We want to keep on making a contribution to employment and enough of the strength of the region in the north, but also in the rest of the Netherlands, and maybe also in the rest of Europe, in the world, because we really need to change together. We want to become the validation lab first of the Netherlands, and this increases the success rates of tens, perhaps hundreds of innovations in the years to come. Examples like this one, for example, Greener, who tested with us at the Leeuwarden Festival, Welcome to the Village. They deliver clean mobile battery energy. By using these big batteries they have right here. And that has resulted in a significant reduction in diesel uses at festivals, but also, for example, at construction sites. Our enthusiasm of using Living Labs to further develop sustainable innovation has been increased and strengthened. The studies concluded by the University of Groningen show that InnoFest helped both the entrepreneurs but also the innovation. This increases our innovation of ambition, but also our confidence that we are on the right track. If it's up to us, we will embark on this adventure together, from festivals to universities, but also from officials to investors. And innovation cannot flourish within a good ecosystem, which was already what Aline was also showing us. Attention to and investment in a sustainable innovation, I think, is crucial. This is urgently needed because the current IPPP report does not cut corners. Sustainability is the motto, and we need to act quickly, but we need to act together. We are increasing our pace because there are still too many entrepreneurs who, despite their passion of their product, work ethic, and smart brain, do not make it. And there are still plenty of people, plenty of living labs in the Netherlands that are still standing still. How can we pursue our dreams and goals together so that they can come up together and we can reach them faster? Let's excel at what we are strong at, and push each other so that we can more easily find one another. Of course, to be honest, this Corona year was really, really, really hard. And I assume that for most of your organization, it also was quite tough. Let therefore the end of 2021 be dominated by three R's: resilience, recovery, and reconsideration. A period in we, together, make the change for change. Let's decide that make the choice for change. Partly because we need to, because the world demands it, but above all, because we really, really want it ourselves. We want to be the ones who are making the change.